Now, will you notice verse 3? The shield of his mighty man is made red. Now, it was not made red, as some think, with blood. The Assyrians were especially fond of the color of red or scarlet. You will find it, well, in all of their art, in their pictures. That is a color that has been discovered there, and they were very much interested in it. They would make everything red. And some believe that they use copper shields, and that in the sunlight, the reflection of copper is red. And actually, that is the thing. And why did they use it? Well, a great many believe that they did it to frighten their enemies. As you well know, that in warfare, you intend to do as much bluffing as you do fighting. You attempt to frighten your enemy as much as you possibly can. You remember when the atom bomb was dropped and first the warning was given. The Japanese, they actually thought that America was bluffing. And that's one time we were not bluffing, but they did not pay any attention to it at all. Today we have a great many of those that are using the crying towel, and we are using flagellations on ourselves that we are guilty of this awful thing. Well, we gave ample warning to the enemy, and it did bring the war to an end. But I'm very frank to say that as we see working out here in this enemy that was brutal, what they sowed, they reaped. And I don't think we're any different. We happen to be the first one to drop an atom bomb. And I'm not sure that God's going to forget that. That was a frightful thing to do, and I personally feel that our nation shouldn't go in sackcloth and ashes because of it today. I see no reason for that. It was an awful, horrible thing. But after all, war was a very awful, horrible thing. And our boys were being slain. We were not winning the war by any means. That was the thing that brought it to a close. And island by island hopping that we were doing in that day just saw the slaughter, in fact, the worst slaughter that we've ever had. And as a result, my feeling is that we were justified in that. But the whole point is that you do attempt to bluff your enemy. And the enemy made the mistake of thinking it was a bluff when we were telling the truth. But that's probably the reason they use red. Now, will you notice it? It says, the shield of his mighty man is made red. The valiant men are in scarlet. Again, red color, you see. They had the uniforms that were red. The chariots shall be with flaming torches in the day of preparation. Now, I think it's because of the armor that was on the chariots and the way that they were built. They were not built of wood like the chariots that you see in the museum down in Egypt. The Egyptians used a great deal of wood in building their chariots. But apparently the Assyrians were the ones that got out the latest model on chariots. They were sort of the General Motors of chariot building. And the chariots were like flaming torches in the day of his preparation, and the fir trees shall be terribly shaken.